John is really such an exceptional person that, you know, he really could be president tomorrow, and he's smart enough to not want the job. Seriously, but he is a leader. In 2019, he testified before Congress about our government's shameful lack of health care for the men and women who responded to the events of September 11th. Yeah, you know, people like my dad who ran into the towers that day, but instead of, you know, giving their lives in a moment, they walked away with a lifetime of illness and pain. And John sat there with those responders behind him and Congress before him and gave the least funny speech he's ever made.
They did their jobs with courage, grace, tenacity, humility. 18 years later, do yours.
So that was, of course, Pete Davidson speaking about Jon Stewart at the when he was getting his Mark Twain Prize. Many other comedians not only lauded Jon Stewart, but also talked about the possibility of him being president, and thus the op-eds were born. There's an op-ed on Politico from Juliana Glover. If Tucker runs in 2024, here's who the Democrats need. And if you're on the podcast, you're not seeing. It is a picture of Jon Stewart beseeching God. I'm not sure what that photo is, but it's gotten serious. The op-ed starts off, perhaps the most important reason for the Democrats to consider Stewart is who he'd be running against. Trump may run. Stewart has far more TV experience. It is plainly much smarter with more agility before crowds. Trump's go-to show of strength has been his ability to pull thousands for his political rallies because they are viewed as entertainment by his supporters. A Stewart rally would be a road show of the most hilarious and civic-minded entertainers known today. Also says, Florida Governor Ron DeSantis and former Vice President Mike Pence seem like they are running. Stewart would just wood chip right through those two stiff as a board speakers. And also goes on to say, you know, what it would mean if Tucker Carlson were to run. And yeah, everybody knows their history with Jon Stewart bodying Tucker Carlson like 15 years ago or whatever. Now I'm gonna jump ahead briefly for time. Jon Stewart tweeted just like 2 days ago, no, thank you. And that's the entire tweet. It doesn't say what he's responding to, but it's easy to imagine that it's the discussion of him potentially running for president, Francesca. What do you make of this?
Well, I was like, can we get lunch on Wednesday? So, and then I saw that tweet and he said, no, thank you. I was like, okay, God. But I really definitely have alerts on his tweets. So I know every time he tweets. I would love for Jon Stewart to run for president. I'm sorry. We need someone who is a no BSer. And I'm so tired. And this is why, like, people like Bernie Sanders have been popular, is because when they speak, it's very difficult to detect their BS. And most politicians have a ton of it, right? Yeah. And that's kind of been Jon Stewart's like clarion call. Like, that's his motto, is no BS, really. When he signed off from The Daily Show, that's effectively what he said. He was like, smell it out wherever it is. And I do think it is very admirable. I know that his fan, like, he and his wife do awesome work in terms of like rescuing factory farm animals. And he's done this work when it comes to 9/11 first responders. And so he has a history of advocacy. And I do think that that can be very effective. It's mostly just me feeling selfish and wanting him to destroy the Republican Party single-handedly. And he absolutely could. Do I think he could govern well? No, but neither can any Democrat. So
yeah,
we're kind of in the same sitch.
And that's not purely speculative. We can look at a recent history. So whenever something like this is raised, especially when, you know, the aspirations are put onto, you know, a celebrity, although this is a celebrity who has spent, you know, decades talking about politics at the very least. They ask, you know, would you support this person? Well, like, we need context. Like, who else is running in theory? Well, first of all, he's apparently not gonna do it. But if it was Jon Stewart or Kamala Harris, yeah, I support John. If it's Jon Stewart or Gavin Newsom or Pete Buttigieg or whatever, well, yeah, no, I'm gonna do that. But do I want Jon Stewart over Katie Porter or AOC or Nina Turner? No, I don't. No, I don't want that at that point. But I wonder how he would be received nationally. I mean, look, he is a dynamic speaker. He can point to a couple of really good things that he's done. I mean, even just the video that Pete Davidson tossed to, that thing that Jon Stewart did there is better than the vast majority of everything a lot of politicians have done through their entire career, let alone if you were to deduct points for all the corruption and all that. But anyway, it doesn't seem like it's going to happen. And I think there are plenty of good progressives who might be far better on the policy, because let's keep it real. I don't know exactly where Jon Stewart or 2022 Jon Stewart stands on all of this. It's been a bit since he was actively opining on a daily basis about the news of the day. We've got a lot of great progressives in theory that could run. Yeah. Having the primary at all is the thing that we should be pushing for.
Yeah. Yeah, but it does speak to what people see in comics, which is a lack of a filter and a truth tellingness and kind of a little bit of a leadership that we do not see. And that's a sad state of affairs. But then you also have like moments like Zelensky in Ukraine, former comic, know, but
well, I don't want to say
he who shall not be named should definitely not run for president. But Jon Stewart, I definitely think we can get behind.
Yeah. Yeah. It's good to have, like, you know, every comedian says that they speak truth of power. It's good to have that actually be speaking truth of power and not just like cover for transphobia. Like, that's a nice change of pace.
Or just speaking truth on Tucker Carlson's show.
Exactly. Yeah, or that kind either.